Hello and welcome to Crypto Interviews. My name is Claudio and this is Crypto Chain, the channel where I do crypto news, reviews, tutorials, and in crypto interviews, of course. And I've got Bitboy here, who's the number one crypto YouTube channel at the moment. He's broke all records, right? Not even Altcoin Daily can surpass him at this stage. So Ben, welcome. Welcome to my channel. And today he's going to be talking about Ethereum, his price predictions, which altcoins he's bullish on. What does he think of crypto in general now? Since the Elon Musk investment and Amazon, could Amazon possibly get into crypto as well? We're going to find that out from Bitboy today. So Ben, welcome to my channel. So please quickly introduce yourself just for the people that don't know who you are. I'm sure everyone does, but just in case.
Needs no introduction. He's a 38-year-old man named Bitboy. Claudio, we've known each other for a long time. We go back to 2018. We used to talk a lot when my channel was much, much, much smaller than it is now. Right now, we are almost 500,000 subscribers. So we are the number one most subscribed to channel in cryptocurrency. We've worked very, very, very hard to get there. We do 3 videos every single day, 1 live stream and 2 pre-recorded videos. We cover everything from crypto news. We talk about charts a little bit on the live stream. We do project reviews and, a lot of different things. Pretty much, if you're in crypto, we probably have something that you'll like.
No, definitely. And what's interesting is those price predictions that you've been doing. I mean, with Ethereum, you've had some crazy price predictions. So please tell us, what do you base those on? And just give us an example on where do you think the price of Ethereum is going to go before the end of this year?
So it's funny. Like sometimes I know you love Polkadot. We're actually gonna do an interview on my channel about Polkadot coins this weekend. I'm a member of a Facebook group that's a Polkadot group. And I went in there last night and I just recently did a price prediction on Polkadot. And I went in, I was reading some of the comments because somebody talked about it in the group. They don't even know I'm in there, kind of hidden in there. And it was like, the people were just like, oh, this guy just pulls these numbers out of his, whatever. He just throws any number out there to whatever. Yeah, I think people would be really shocked if they knew how much research and time and formulas and coming up with a good strategic way to make these price predictions, I think they'd be really surprised. And when it comes to Ethereum, we did some really cool ways of coming up with this price prediction. And the overall prediction, we believe by the end of this year, we believe by Halloween this year, will be $27,000 for Ethereum. In the short term, we're looking at $3,000 by the end of the month. I know my $2,500 by Valentine's Day doesn't look like it's coming true, but we're going to end up pretty close, I think, to it. I think next week we should be looking at Ethereum challenging $2,500 and then $3,000 by the end of the month. So that's kind of in the short term. Sometime over the summer, maybe hitting about $10,000 in retracing before getting a final push up. So, that's kind of our prognostication on where we think that Ethereum is heading to.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And we've seen some astronomical growths in the altcoin space as well in general. I mean, we've seen 10Xs, we've seen 20Xs, and we've seen 100Xs. I mean, Elrond has been pumping like crazy in the last couple of months. There's no stopping it. I mean, it made some people millionaires, to be honest. Anyone that got into Elrond before the summer, in the spring of 2020, are millionaires now. There's no doubt about it.
Absolutely.
Pretty much, right?
Well, I mean, we did a video on Elrond a couple of weeks ago, and even after we've done the video, it's 5X from there. So, I mean, that's definitely one that, is doing big things and still making people money, even though, the best opportunity is gone from that.
No, definitely. Yeah. And even Polkadot's been doing very good as well, considering it started like 280, even less at IEO price. I think it was like 150 or something before they actually started at IOU price, before it was transferable. That's the word I was looking for. So you could trade it on the exchange, but not transfer it.
Oh, yeah, that's right. On Binance, right? Had that. Yeah, I remember.
Absolutely crazy. But anyway, tell me, which altcoins are you most bullish on based on all of the research that you've done, including the sponsored content and stuff? Like, I mean, even with the sponsored content, a lot of those can be have potential. Can do potentially well, right? And the question is, which ones, like, if you had to pick your top three, which ones would you say are going to do well in 2021? Because 2022 is still long away for crypto, right?
Yeah. So my top three projects right now that we're looking at, I would say Elrond is one of those. Because, I know everybody wants the 500X, out of the blue. Nobody knows what it is coin. Badger DAO is a great one. And APY Finance is another one we've done a lot of research on that has that kind of potential. but your new person in the market isn't on that degen level. I know we prefer when people are investing in projects that are much more reliable, have been around for much longer, and things like that. Elrond is one of those projects that still has massive potential. If you look at kind of the hype around Elrond, it's very high. And we've just seen what it's 5X here in the last few weeks. And I don't think it's going to stop anytime soon. I think this is one that's going to continue to make new all-time highs. It's got a great team behind it. It's got great support. In all of cryptocurrency, it's got the number two most engaged community right behind Cardano. Never know which finger's which till I raise it. Right behind Cardano, that you guys can see, I got a pillow right back there. We love Cardano. We love Ethereum. We think they have great potential. But in terms of other projects that I would say have a lot of potential for new investors, I would say Synthetics is another one that we really, really, really like, kind of underrated. It's a top 50 project. It is a DeFi project. We know that is going to be hot. We're kind of heading into the second round of DeFi, if you will. We know over the summer, things absolutely exploded. So that's one we definitely looked at, and we said this one has real-world potential. It's if people don't know what Synthetics is, it's basically a way to create synthetic derivative versions of any asset out there in the world and to be able to use that to invest in things you couldn't invest in due to, let's say, regulation or where you live or things like that. So
is that like NFTs?
No, it's not NFTs. It's they actually call them synths. So S-Y-N-T-H. They're derivative paper versions of like Apple or like or of stocks or stocks. Oil or other commodities or gold. Anything you can invest in, there is a synthetic version of it. And it's basically just like derivatives, right? I mean, when you look back at the Bitcoin futures contracts and the Ethereum futures contracts, both from the CME, those are what we call paper Bitcoin or paper Ethereum because they're just derivatives. You're not actually, you're settling them with dollars. You're not settling them with actual crypto like the back futures contracts, for instance. So we think the potential of that one to be the mammoth in DeFi is definitely very, very high. I've got no relation to any of these teams. I haven't been, no sponsored content. We have done some sponsored content for Elrond. We did a follow-up video to our big video that wasn't sponsored. We just did it out of the blue and they liked it, wanted us to show them about wanted me to show my audience the Mayar wallet that was really big that they launched with the hero tags. Yeah. Easy way for people to send crypto. So those are some projects that we really like. Those two specifically are very underrated, we think. And then from there, I'm kind of like looking through my list of ones that I really like. I think the graph is one that's been pumping lately. Really love the graph. It's one of these things that's doing its own thing. It's a blockchain explorer basically for blockchain data, not for blockchain transactions. It's like the Google of blockchain. And it's a way, not like a decentralized version of searching the internet. It's a way to search blockchain. And I think no one else is doing anything like that.
Yeah.
When you look at the use case for something like that, that every blockchain can make, can make viable and make use of, I think it's got a lot of potential. So I would say Graph is definitely one of the top three that we're looking at right now. One of my biggest holdings.
Definitely. People in my community have been talking about that one as well. So they're going to like it.
Very interesting.
Yeah. No, that's good. That's good. No, thank you for the picks. Now, to move on and talk about Elon Musk, I mean, what's your take on this, on the investment, and what's your take on him constantly pumping Dogecoin? I mean, he said he got his son a small bag just to be a small hodler. I mean, do you believe him with that, or do you think he just...
Yeah, I believe him. I mean, I think he's like, look, there are people in the world that you can't believe a thing that they say. The Jeff Bezoses, the Mark Zuckerbergs. You can't believe anything these people say. They're so fake and plastic and robotic that you just can't put value or stock in the things and the directions where they want to point you to. We all know where the world's going, to this crazy techocracy where these guys are trying to control everything and control governments and things like that. There are other people that just come off and you understand when they're talking that there's actually depth to what they're saying. And those people tend to be overshares. They tend to be people that are looser with their lips, if you will. They're people that just say stuff because they're not afraid to say what they really believe. And I know on my channel, we've certainly been guilty of that, where we say things probably that might get us in trouble, or we're just honest. We try to be honest. Yeah. I see that same quality in Elon Musk. People may not like it. And for a lot of people, it's so hard for them to grasp why Elon Musk would not like just go buy a bunch of Dogecoin. He's already the richest man in the world.
Yes. Yeah.
But why he wouldn't just go get $10 million worth of Dogecoin and pump it to $1 billion. But I think he's an honest guy and he wouldn't do that. I think he probably doesn't own any. I bet he probably owns hardly any Dogecoin. I bet he probably has more in the thousands than in the millions or the hundreds of thousands. I think he's got some for fun. He likes to watch it. He don't need the money. He probably did get his son a little bag of it or whatever. But when you really see what he's doing, you see where he's putting his money. He's buying Bitcoin. Now, we don't know how much Bitcoin he owns. We don't know how much SpaceX owns because it's not a public company. We do know that Tesla now owns $1.5 billion worth of Bitcoin. So you see where the money is going and what they really believe in and what he really believes in. But Dogecoin is for fun. I mean, he just seems like a nice, honest guy. He likes to get out there and have fun with people. He likes to use his platform to not just do the run-of-the-mill stuff. And I really respect him. And, you know, hopefully one day we'll be able to get him on the channel. It'd be real fun.
Well, that's going to be very hard, I think, because I was thinking of ways to get him on the channel. And the only way I could find was to send a CV for a job application for SpaceX.
Oh, that's interesting. Well, you know, I would have thought it might have been impossible, but I actually saw another YouTuber out there. I guess he's in LA, I assume. Or maybe he's moved to Texas at this point. I don't think so yet. But another YouTuber actually got him off the cuff on a candid interview on the street, and he's hadn't talked to him for a while. And so gave me a little more hope that maybe he would be flexible enough to come on a channel like mine that has a platform that we do and talk Bitcoin and Dogecoin and cryptocurrency. It'd be fun.
No, definitely. Sure. I respect him. Joe Rogan managed to get him, but Joe Rogan's a huge figure in the US, right? I mean,
I want to get on Joe Rogan. That's my next target. I was on Alex Jones this week, looking to be on Joe Rogan next. So, wow. Joe, have your people call my people.
No, yeah, good luck with that. I mean, if you can get Elon Musk, that's going to be absolutely huge. I mean, he's helped one crypto YouTuber on that tutorial that he did about Dogecoin. Remember the one that he tweeted a tutorial. He said, this is a tutorial of Dogecoin and what it's about. And the dude has like 200K subscribers or something.
That.
No, he's got a big channel, but it's cartoonish.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, I haven't heard of him before until Elon Musk. So, yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if he puts you on, you're definitely going to get a lot of subscribers.
No, for sure. For sure. Now, to move on from Elon Musk, because we know, you know, he's likely going to get other people like corporations to invest in crypto. What's your take on Amazon now since the CEO left? And is the new CEO more bullish on crypto as people are seeing in the news? And what's your take on Amazon using crypto? Because this is something that has been discussed back in 2017. There was some speculation that they've got this website where they're going to accept crypto. At the moment, I believe you can only use like an extension, like a browser extension to top up with crypto. And then it does a swap for you in fiat and you can purchase stuff on Amazon. But for Amazon to actually accept crypto, do you think that's even possible now?
Well, I think that right now they're not going to be accepting crypto. I mean, we have ways to spend crypto on Amazon. You could get a crypto.com card and you can do it that way. So there are ways that you can. But right now, I can't really comment on how bullish the new guy is. I haven't really looked into it yet. I know Jeff Bezos probably owns a lot of Bitcoin, but you know, isn't publicly saying anything favorable about it. Seems like an obvious opportunity for a coin, an Amazon coin, so the money stays within the ecosystem. I mean, they got the Prime memberships. I'm sure there's some way they can integrate all that together in the Prime Video. I mean, there's a lot there. But, you know, we just got news that they're testing some kind of digital payment in Mexico starting later this year. So, you know, I think there's a lot of opportunity for Amazon. I don't think they've milked that opportunity yet. I don't know. Maybe the opportunity doesn't have teats. But I do think, sorry, this is the kind of
content it's all right.
You get to on my channel. I do think that it makes a lot of sense, but we haven't seen it yet. And that makes you wonder why. Like, is there something that's preventing them to do it? Is there a fear of regulation or is there a fear that, you know, Amazon right now is built in a centralized way and that maybe a decentralized marketplace could take over in the future and they don't want to encourage cryptocurrency? That could also be an angle.
No, definitely. And that's huge. I mean, we just got to give them time because Elon Musk fueled the already started bull run. And all we can expect now is probably giants like Apple to get into crypto, Amazon, who else? Google, Oracle. I mean, there's so many, right? IBM they've had some deals with Stellar back in the day, right? And I don't know what they're going to do now. But anyway, I mean, any last words that you've got for the community? What piece of advice would you give them? Like, especially to new people, because there are a lot of new people in the space now.
Yeah, I think the number one piece of advice that I've been giving people right now is things are very bullish right now, and they're going to continue to be. The cryptocurrency is going to continue increasing in value. Almost all coins are going to go up throughout this year. By the end of the year, that will change. I believe we will end this bull run by the end of this year, and that people need to really be looking for opportunities eventually to have a plan, not just for this bull cycle, but for the next bull cycle. A lot of people, I understand where you're at financially. You don't have a lot of money. You don't have money set aside, especially if you're newer. You're just getting into this because of the allure of retiring or having a lot of money or whatever the case may be. And the fact is, it's going to be real hard for you guys to turn $1,000 into $1 million in this bull run. But if you listen to people that know what they're talking about, like Claudio does with Polkadot and things we talk about on my channel, then hopefully we're going to be able to direct you in a way to be able to get those profits this year, wait for the next bear market to hit, and be able to maximize your profits in the next cycle. And that's how I believe people will really make truly life-changing money like a lot of us have been able to do who've been in this for a long time. Just want to share that message to people that it can happen. You got to be smart. It won't happen overnight. Don't get scammed. Be careful. Don't fall for the shortcuts. Those are usually the scams. Do your research, learn about crypto, and then you'll really unlock what a life-changing opportunity this is.
That's it. Do your research and be careful. Stay safe as always. Thank you very much, Ben, for joining. If you haven't already subscribed to Bitboy Crypto's channel, the link can be found in the description of this video and also in the pinned comment. So it's going to make it very easy for you to just go click on it and then subscribe. That's it. Very simple. Thank you very much for coming on, and I'll see you in the future. Take care.
All right.
Stay safe. Thanks. Bye-bye.